Hi guys, I am Black. Welcome back to my channel. My name is Louis MFO. So in today's video, I am going to be showing you how to do a frontal reconstruction. So this is actually the fourth time I am using this frontal. So apparently to some people, this frontal is literally useless. But I want to see how I am going to transform this. And I'm also going to be showing you guys, so when you are in my situation today, maybe sometime you'll be able to tackle this. So if this sounds like something you'll be interested in, this video is definitely for you and you need to keep watching. So I went on to prep my model's skin. You guys, I have been hammering on this whole prep thing, bald cap thing before an installation. So I am going to leave one of my balding video up there, so you guys go check it out. And then I'll also leave a video where I talked about some of the reasons why you should bald a client's head before doing a full installation. So I am going to go ahead and apply the units, but first we're going to fit the wig on the client's head. So that's one of the reasons why we're doing this, because we wouldn't want a situation where we are done with our proper glue application and then trying to, you know, fit the wig might end up ruining whatever you've done. So I always say this in my videos, when I am doing a frontal reconstruction, or rather when I'm doing a proper install for someone, I like them to have their forehead after the whole installation process. I'm not one of those people who put the frontal on the person's head and the person will end up looking like she's wearing a helmet. So we don't do that here. So that's why we like to take all this, we like to follow all the steps while we're doing our installation. So you guys can see I'm trying to take out all the hairs that are on the glue we applied before to lay the bald cap. So as soon as I'm done with that, I'm going to get my glue So the glue we're using in today's video is from Love Beauty, so you guys go check them out. And thanks to them for sponsoring the groundbreaking experience workshop in South Africa. So you guys, I am not trying to sell them because they sponsor the class, but you know how we do it here. If something works for me and I enjoy using it, I like to hook you guys up so that you know, just enjoy the whole luxury of that product. So I'm going to do the C thing we normally do in all of our videos and then spread it using the rattle comb and then allow it clear. For today's installation, I am going to be doing two glue applications. And if you guys notice, you see that after this first one, I am going to let it clear properly before I then come again and put the second layer. So once it clears, I'm going to make it tacky using my dryer, and then I am going to place the unit and then tie it. I like to tie it because it helps the frontal to adhere to the skin. So it's customization time, and before I start plucking, I like to do a middle part. You guys, we always talk about this in all of our videos. So if you're new here to this channel and you're new to how we do things here, first of all, I want to welcome you. Thanks for stopping by. I know you're going to like it here, so do subscribe and turn on the notification bell so you always be that first special person to be notified whenever we have a new video here. So after this video, you have every right to go check out some of my videos, and don't forget to have fun and also share with your friends, because you know, like we always say here, sharing is caring. So back to business. I am going to section it. So we're sectioning some centimeters away from where we have the glue, so you can actually see it from, you know, the shine. That's why I always advise to have a light in front of you when you're doing an install, so you'll be able to like see what you're doing. So once I'm done with that, I'm going to quickly use my hot comb, because I want that part to just stay down while I extend to the other one. So I'm going to take from the tail of the brows and then section it into the head, and then take out. So you're going to do like a number 7, and that part is going off the frontal. So apparently I am trying to customize this frontal to, you know, fit the person wearing it, because like I said, we know they do helmet kind of install here. So once I'm done with this part, I'm going to pluck the hairs. So when you're doing this, please, you have to be careful, because if you are heavy-handed, you might end up ripping the lace, and we don't want that. So I'm going to do the same thing I did here to the other side, and then I'm going to come back and then pluck it. So I want you guys to pay attention. Thank you. So I always recommend my plucking technique to everyone. You see, because of the way I plucked this hair, I am able to reuse this frontal for the fourth time. So check out my video on how to pluck so you can, you know, follow up on how to pluck like a pro without leaving bald spots on the frontal. So I'm going to leave it up there so you guys go check it out.
Thank you.
So that will be the end of today's video. I know you guys got a lot of tricks and hacks on how to, you know, manage a frontal that seems useless. So I hope it was really insightful and you guys really enjoyed it. Don't forget to subscribe to my channel if you're yet to, and also give this video a very big thumbs up. Like my other videos, watch them, share them with your friends, because you know, like I always say, sharing is caring. And also don't forget to turn on the notification bell so you always be the first to know whenever I post a video. Oh yes, if you missed my last workshop, I have it on Thinkific. So you can go click the link in my bio on Instagram, or I'll definitely leave it here.